Seven Days to Die is a rather deep and complex game, and it can be a little bit overwhelming, especially for brand new players. So today, I'm going to go over some tips and tricks for beginners. These little tidbits of information will hopefully make your gameplay a little bit easier. Now, while these tips and tricks are targeted at beginners, many of these techniques you will actually use throughout the game. So let's get started with some tips and tricks for beginners in 7 Days to Die. The first tip I want to discuss actually occurs before you start a new game. 7 Days to Die is extremely customizable. You can change a whole host of settings, including the difficulty setting, the 24-hour cycle, which changes how long in real time a 24-hour cycle will last, the Blood Moon frequency, which determines how often you'll have to deal with Blood Moon hordes. You can adjust the speed of the zombies, whether or not you want them to walk, sprint, or run. You can change the amount of experience that you get. You can change how much damage you do to certain blocks, or how much damage the zombies do to blocks. You can adjust your loot abundance. That's how much loot you actually get from containers. You can adjust the loot respawn time. That determines the number of days that have to pass before loot will respawn in containers. You can adjust how often you get airdrops, and whether or not those airdrops are marked on your map. And you can even change whether or not enemies will spawn at all. In fact, if this is your first time playing 7 Days to Die, I would highly recommend starting a brand new game and turning the enemy spawning off. And then go ahead and start that game and play for like an hour or so, just so you can familiarize yourself with the controls in 7 Days to Die. As I said, 7 Days to Die is a rather complex game, and it may take you a little bit of time to familiarize yourself with the controls. Which buttons do what, the basics of crafting, all of the little details that are extremely important to be successful in this game. So if you're brand new to the game, I would highly recommend turning your enemy spawning off, start a new game, and then play for an hour or so, just so you can get a handle on the basics of 7 Days to Die. And once you have the basics down, you can go ahead and exit out of that game and start up a regular playthrough of 7 Days to Die. Now, once you're ready to jump into 7 Days proper, I would caution against bumping up the difficulty settings too high. In fact, your first regular playthrough, you might want to do under Scavenger. But again, that is completely up to you. Whatever you feel comfortable with, go with that. You can always go back and adjust the settings later if you find that the game is a little bit too difficult. But once you have your settings exactly where you want them, go ahead and hit that start button, and we will take a look at tip number 2. Once you hit that start button, you're gonna come to a loading screen like this. Take your time on this loading screen because it is chock full of a lot of useful information. As you see down here, there are 30 different tips that you can read through to learn about this game. And all you have to do is use the left and right mouse button to click over to the next tip. Spend some time going through this and reading these tips. There is a lot of extremely useful information in these tips. So while you're waiting for your game to load, go through these tips and read what they have available. Now that you've spawned into your world, you will start off with this little pop-up here. Started Basics of Survival. This is your beginner quests. The next tip on my list is get these beginner quests done as quickly as possible. Don't waste time. Get these quests done ASAP. In order to complete these quests, you're going to need 4 basic items. You're going to need plant fibers, wood, stone, and feathers. Plant fibers can be found pretty much anywhere. All you have to do is punch grass. Wood can be found by punching these little woody bushes. Or you can also hack down trees. You can either punch them, or once you have your stone axe crafted, you can use your stone axe to hack down a tree to get a bunch of wood. Small stones can be found everywhere, just littered about. Look around and pick up those small stones. And feathers can be found by searching birds' nests. So now that you know where to get the items you're gonna need, do not waste any time. Get these starter quests done ASAP. And while you're doing your starter quests, try not to leave your spawn area. Don't stray too far, because while you are in the spawn, the initial spawn point, you are going to be relatively safe from zombies. They should not spawn in your initial spawn point. And there we go, ladies and gentlemen. Beginning quests are done, and our trader has been marked on the map. Now, before we make our way to the trader, there are a couple of more things that you want to craft before you head out. Go ahead and craft yourself up a couple of stone spears and craft yourself up a shovel. The reason we wanted to craft up our stone spears is simple. You want to keep the zombies at a distance, especially early game. And the stone spear early game is the easiest way to do that. It has a much longer reach than some of the other weapons like the club. Plus, its power attack allows you to throw the spear, meaning that you can keep an even bigger distance. So now that our beginner quests are done and our stone spears and shovels have been crafted, the next tip is get your butt to the trader as soon as you can. The next tip I have for beginners is, as you're making your way to the trader, be on the lookout for stumps. These little guys are very, very important because not only do they provide you with wood, but they can also provide you with honey. So as you're making your way to the trader, be on the lookout for these stumps and go ahead and bash these little guys down, because they can yield honey. Honey is extremely important because it can cure infections. Infections early game are killers, and you want to take care of those as soon as possible. So while I would recommend heading straight for the trader, if you come across any of these stumps, go ahead and make a pit stop to break them down. That way you can stockpile some honey. And here we are at the trader's. The next tip I have for you is get inside and completely loot this compound. Loot every single lootable container that you can. Once you're done looting, go ahead and introduce yourself to the trader. And we're going to take a look at his inventory. First thing we're going to do is we're going to sell him all of the stuff that we do not need right away. Once you've sold everything to the trader that you do not need, go ahead and take a look at his inventory. Be on the lookout for a couple of items. First, see if he has any cheap firearms available. Getting your hands on a firearm early on in the game can be a huge benefit. Also, be on the lookout for a cooking pot. If he has a cooking pot, go ahead and buy that. Finding a cooking pot on day one can be a lifesaver. So getting your hands on a firearm and a cooking pot at the very start of the game can make things a lot easier. The next tip I want to talk about is vending machines. Every single trader has a working vending machine inside his or her compound. Vending machines are an excellent source of food and water. And the great thing is they restock every single day. So if you stay relatively close to your trader, you will always have access to a working vending machine. That will give you an unlimited supply of food and drink. The next little trick I want to show you folks has to do with frames. Frames are your best friends. They are extremely versatile pieces of equipment in this game. Now, let's say you are out and about and you come across a wolf. Now, you want to try to stay away from wildlife early on in the game, but let's say you can't, or let's say that the wolf starts chasing you. Well, all you need to do is toss down a frame, hop on top of it, and jump and place another one down. This is what we call a nerd pull. And all you have to do is pull up too high. That's all you have to do. Just go up too high. Upgrade this one right here. So once you have your little nerd pull created here, you are perfectly safe from the wolf. So we can go ahead and get his attention. Hey, buddy. And he will come over and start attacking our structure. But he's going to start attacking the second block here. But it's been upgraded. We're good. We can either continue to upgrade, repair it as needed, or you can pull out your spear and start taking care of the wolf. You're perfectly 100% safe. And just like that, the wolf is dead. So now we can go ahead and use our knife to harvest up some meat from the wolf. And we'll pick up our second frame here and head on out and about on our merry business. Do not discount the importance of frames. Not only can they get you out of sticky situations, they can also be used to nerd pull up buildings to get to higher places, and they can also be used to build basic structures. Frames are your friends. The next tip I want to talk about is picking a place to call home. I would highly recommend either picking a POI very close to the trader, or building in an open field close to the trader. Whatever you decide to do, it is very important that the trader is nearby. Because in 7 Days to Die, traders are the hub of this game. They are the ones that send you on quests so you can loot and get money. They have inventories of items for you to purchase. Plus, they have the vending machines, which are extremely important, especially early game. So when choosing a place to call home, try to pick a POI or a build location that is close to the trader. Now, no matter where you choose to live or how you choose to play this game, the most important thing to remember is have fun. There is no right or wrong way to play 7 Days to Die. This game is extremely customizable, meaning you can play in a variety of different ways, and however you choose to play is perfectly okay. The main thing to remember is have some fun, folks. Now, if you're new to 7 Days to Die and you're looking for more information to help you get started, I've created a very special playlist of beginner's guides that you can access by clicking the box in the top right corner of the screen. But for now, this is Savin saying thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me in Savin's World. And remember, the average gamer is always king of the hill on the bell curve.